Good morning, everyone. So I'm broadcasting from RAL this morning, a presentation about CERN VMFS infrastructure for EGI VOs. So the outline of this presentation is a short overview about what is CVMFS, and then this presentation split in three parts about impact on user communities, on national grid initiatives, and on system administrators. And at the end, brief conclusion, references, and question and answers session. About CVMFS. It was developed at CERN to help them with CERN virtual machines for easy update of software rather than upload every single time a new virtual image. It is a read-only file system, which now is widely used to access high-energy physics experiment software and condition data. The files and directories are hosted on standard web servers and mounted in this universal namespace, which is /CVMFS. The file data and metadata are downloaded on demand and locally cached. Probably most of us know that in the last 3 years, CVMFS has a big impact in the distribution of experiment software and condition data within WLCG with these four LHC experiments. What it does, it removes the necessity of local installation jobs, also removes the necessity of having NFS servers, which usually are heavy loaded. It removes local software tagging process. And once it is installed, the software starts to be available at any sites with the CVMFS client installed. All is about a robust, decentralized network of repository replicas. It's not necessarily a host history now, but is an overview. By April 2014, so next year, the main LHC experiments will no longer run any installation jobs. Everything will be based on CVMFS. And the number of CVMFS servers around the world is increasing, starting to be more than nothing. At the end of last year, RAL Tier 1 offered a non-LHC Stratum Zero infrastructure, initially to virtual organization supported by Grid PPUK project. It was extended and now is about to be fully replicated at CERN. And as a part of this EGI umbrella, we are in discussions with NICEF to do dual mirroring between us. Maybe what I forgot to specify, this part, first part about the CVMFS is was presented at the EGI Community Forum in April at Manchester. But I think it is worth to put it here. About a few words about the WLCG deployment. It's about a central repository, Stratum Zero repository hosted at CERN, which is replicated to a network of Stratum 1 servers located in Europe, United States, and Asia. And beyond this Stratum 1 network, a distributed hierarchy of proxy servers fetches the content from the closest Stratum 1. and delivers the data to more local sites or clients. And the CVMFS clients connect to one of the Stratum 1 via local SQUID caches. The mechanism has the advantage that relies on a transparent failover to Stratum 1 service in case of connections problems to the main Stratum 1. About the benefits, so you install it once and you run it everywhere, anywhere, with, of course, with the clients installed at worker node levels. It is a read-only file system, and it is easily scalable with standard tools. It's SQUID, caches, and proxies, nothing else. And everything is over the HTTP protocol. Usually, it offers better performance, comparing with sometime high network traffic because of NFS servers. Also, in the case of diskless worker nodes, where clients are hard to be installed because of space, the latest production release of CVMFS has a feature that you can re-export the client via NFS. So there is a solution even for diskless worker nodes. Now coming to our main subject, the non-LFC use. It is that clearly is firmly established for WLCG. So now we started to look for other communities, and also other communities started to contact us. So we know that there are several Stratum Zeros across the globe. During the recent kickoff meeting with CVMFS Task Force, we find out about other location where CVMFS is running for small VOs. And I think the real benefit will come if we are able to create a network similar to WLCG one. We are in a good position because the small VOs will not be guinea pig to implement CVMFS. I would say we can take the best achievements from CVMFS deployment within WLCG, and we could create a proper CVMFS infrastructure for EJ VOs using the expertise from WLCG. So what we discussed in last April, we have put this question, who is interested in trying CVMFS? We are concerned more or less if there are different requirements for small VOs, for non-high energy physic VOs. And we started to look how to build this resilient scalable network to support them. And yes, we are looking for communities interested in to use this technology. What will be needed to make it work? We need multiple Stratum Zeros where to store, let's say, the master copy of software. The VOs will need to be able to install the software or upload the tarballs. Sites need to manage to publish this repository. But a good thing is that Stratum Zeros do not require 100 uptime. What requires close to 100 uptime is this network of replicas, Stratum 1s, which have to provide the resilience. They are pulling data from Stratum Zeros. They need some storage. Well, the estimation is some terabyte storage but in initial stages, probably not just like that. And in order to be able to sustain, let's say, an increased number of requests, we usually put reverse proxy accelerators in front. But the service level agreement, we aim to be similar to that expected from tier ones, so high one. Also, CVMFS proxy servers have a big role in this infrastructure because they are fetching the content from the closest Statum 1 and they are serving the CVMFS clients. So we do not want each client from each Orca node to contact the Stratum 1. We want to have a number or a large number of proxy servers. The configuration is trivial and is minimal effort to maintain. What is needed is this resource to be made available. Also, definitely, obviously, the CVMFS client suite has to be installed and configured on batch farms. But the expertise is already available at many sites which are supporting LXCVOs. And also experts are ready to help new participating sites. And the last but not the least, we need enthusiasts. Now, about CVMFS for user communities. Okay, so no questions here. Okay, so I try to highlight advantages, disadvantages, actions to be taken, and maybe some goals to achieve. Advantages for user communities and maybe especially for VO managers. There is a single point where to upload and maintain the master copy of the software, which is a big difference with times when VO managers had to upload the software in several places. The rest is done by the replication mechanism down to Stratum 1 mesh and beyond to the worker nodes cache via the squids. There is no longer need for multiple NFS mounts across the grid. If VO has more than one point of presence, so if today they have two or three NFS servers and NFS mounting points to maintain, with CVMFS, it is only just one single point, so the work will be halved or even less. Also, another advantage, unique definition for this environment variable, VO software directory. Everywhere, the environment would contain something like /CVMFS/VO repository name. And usually, a single installation job is needed to run at the site hosting the Stratum 0 repository for that VO for upload and maintenance. There are possible alternatives in the case where installation jobs cannot be run at the site which is storing the Stratum 0 for that VO. So we are currently developing a RAL web interface which will allow tarball uploads and unpacking and also basic file system operation on CVMFS space. Also, I know that other places are allowing power users to have read-write access into the same CVMFS repository. And I think other case scenarios can be discussed if need be. As a disadvantage, what I can say is that the repository are word readable. This is a CVMFS limitation. I don't know if further releases will sort this out. From what I discussed with LHC users, this is not a problem for them. They are considering the software distribution and data put in CVMFS as open source. It might not be the case with all views, non-LHC views, small views. I can tell us an example, but I don't know at all details about biomed. It's about medicine. It might be some private data there. I don't know. This is indeed a problem. But I couldn't find, honestly, anything against CVMFS to be deployed. As some actions which I try to identify, well, view managers should express interest and contact us. There is a CVMFS task force in its early stages. We had a kickoff meeting. We have a wiki page. We have a mailing list. We plan to meet face to face in 2 weeks' time at the technical forum, and then to continue with regular meetings over the Adobe connector, over the internet. Another option is to contact the appropriate National Grid Initiative or Stratum Zeros close to, let's say, to that VO, if it's a local VO, regional VO. So along with RAL Tier 1, other sites, I have been told, will act as a regional EGI CVMFS Stratum Zero soon. South Africa, Finland, Netherlands. Another action, VO managers to identify cases where VOs are supported by both EGI and OSG in the States or maybe other organization, which I am not aware of them. In such a way, we can make the software distribution more homogeneous. We don't have to run Stratum Zero here and Stratum Zero at OSG. And there is a, let's say, informal agreement that will insert our Stratum 1s with, or let's say Stratum 1s in EGI with Stratum 1 in OSG to make a more powerful network of replicas. And as an ultimate goal, I can quote here, we are making use of it already very nice and simple. You can check on the wiki page, on CVMFS Task Force wiki page, who said that. So my proposal would be, what about having a lot of your managers saying the same in 6-12 months time? I don't think it's too much to ask. Another topic is CVMFS for NGIs. How can they help and what would be a goal for them? How can NGIs help? Definitely they need to support CVMFS. They need to understand site availability, to install clients, and to collect expression of interest from VOs. They need definitely to support and to encourage CVMFS client suites to be installed and configured at sites. We need probably their support for emerging Stratum Zero sites. Also, assistance is required to help Stratum One network to take shape. But much more help is required, in my opinion, to deploy and maintain an hierarchy of proxy servers. Is it helpful to have access to Squid Farm service. If there are no such service, 1-2 slots from the farm can be redeployed and dedicated for Squid Farm service. But also dedicated CVMFS squid nodes are very useful to be located close to the batch farms. Optimal would be at least one such service per country. Ideally would be such service at each site. And as I said, yes, probably is a repeat here, the NGIS have to, at some point, maybe to persuade SAIS to install the CVMFS client if they are not already installed for other VOs or for LHC VOs. And minimal changes otherwise, well, if there are squids running, you just need to add CVMFS to one endpoint and the client will be able to access data from Stratum 1. So as an ultimate goal for NGIS is to have, again, CVMFS client installed by default on batch farms, and with the same importance to have CVMFS squid service per each NGI. Now, CVMFS for system administrators, how to convince them what they really have to do and the ultimate goal for them. So one point is they don't need any longer to maintain the NFS service to store the software at each batch farm. And they should take into account that there is a simple procedure to install and configure the CVMFS client at worker node level. Also, as I said earlier, there are solutions available for diskless worker nodes where CVMFS clients cannot be installed. There is this re-export feature in the last client release. There is easy access to an active CVMFS community via mailing list where developers, sysadmins involved in CVMFS for WLCG are taking part. About the real work needed, well, to install the latest CVMFS client production release across the entire farm, client version 2.1 is the current production one, and there is documentation, and there is a starting point in documentation at SIR. And also, well, it's a technical side, to modify that VO software directory environment to point to the CVMFS mounting point. And another good thing, once the CVMFS client is configured for one VO, it is easy to replicate, very easy to replicate for further ones. On existing squids, you just need to add the necessary CVMFS Stratum endpoint, and you are done. It is not complicated, but people might be reluctant. And as an ultimate goal for system administrator, maybe to make the CVMFS client part of the standard worker node installation. So, as a conclusion, so, if you are representing a VO or you are a VO manager you are really willing to make use of CVMFS, if you are a site willing to deploy CVMFS client, if you are a site willing to run a Stratum 0 repository, or you are a site willing to run a Stratum 1 replica, then contact CVMFS Task Force. We are in our early stage, but we want to develop and we want to embark as many as possible people representing views, sites, NGIs. As references, I added the CVMFS Task Force wiki page, the CVMFS homepage at CERN, and the RAL Tier 1 CVMFS, where you can find other links, helpful links regarding CVMFS. So, just to specify that I'm not the only one or the best expert in CVMFS at RAL Tier 1. I started recently, and I started with EGI VOs, so I might not know all the answers, honestly.
We're now open to question and answer time. Kostas, I can see you've got your hand up. Do you want to fire next?
Yeah, my question is more about, let's say, the hierarchy model. Is it possible, for example, to have more than one Statum 0 for one site or one Statum 1 service? Is there a bigger plan how to create, for example, a Stratum 1 hierarchy module and then allow each VO to have its own Stratum 0?
We need a good network of or a good presence of CVMFS SQUID service on each NGI. Stratum 1s is not a problem. We do not need Stratum 1s on each NGI. At least how things are at the moment and how we predict them to develop. For WLCG, there are 3 or 4 Stratum 1s in total. So we think we need a similar number of Stratum 1s for the time being. One Stratum 1 will be at RAL. The cost will be absorbed probably by the grid PP, and there are signals that NICEF will host a Stratum 1. Also, Stratum 1s do not have to replicate everything. They can replicate just a part of the entire repository, so they do not need to contact all Stratum zeros and to replicate. It's just what they want to replicate. But I expect that at some point every VO heavy software VO to be replicated in at least 2 Stratum ones. For proxies, we also expect that NGIs to absorb the cost. It's about, I think, mainly who is going to run that machine and to put some effort to maintain it. So if something is coordinated, it should be at the NGI level. But we will be following the WLCG infrastructure for CVMFS, which proved to be successful.
I have a question about Stratum 1 servers, because in your slides you've mentioned also a network of regional Stratum 0 servers. What would be the function of that and how this relates to the tree hierarchy you've just presented?
So Stratum 0, we expect to be on the best effort, but also we expect them to appear as long as VO managers make a request for them to be located. So at this very moment, we can say that RAL Tier 1 can support all VOs, but this probably will be within limits at some point in the future. At some point, we'll get maybe we'll have too many VOs to host, but I assume that by that time, Stratum 0 will have many Stratum 0 which will start to host VOs. I don't know who. We cannot point to other sites. You have to do it because we are doing. But from the recent kickoff meeting and some mails on the mailing list, we found out that people at least are running local Stratum 0, but they say they are willing to collaborate. So I would expect at some point they will host not only local VOs, but regional VOs and further.
We've got one that seems from Sorina okay. Pop in CNRS. Sorina, do you want to go ahead?
Okay, hello. So I'm not sure I understood how replicas are handled at the Stratum 1 level. Are they automatically, so data is automatically replicated, or is the data owner responsible to replicating it?
The data owner is responsible only to run the installation job or to make sure the tarball is uploaded either automatically, let's say using this power user facility, or a web interface, or handing to site admins at Stratum Zero. But once the software is uploaded into the Stratum Zero repository, it is published, and then I didn't enter into details, but Stratum ones are connecting with cron jobs every hour, and they are downloading the changes, incremental changes from Stratum Zero. So everything is automatically, and it usually propagates within 2 hours from the Stratum Zero up to the lowest to the worker node level.
Does it use automatically the closest replica? Do you have such a system to use the closest replica?
It is about the configuration at the worker node level. The first choice should be the closest replica, okay, but also it should contain at least failover replica. It's about the client. You do not care have to care about this stuff. You just need to access /CVMFS VO name.
Do you think we would need some structure for that for users and the site managers that have to learn how to install the clients locally?
Yes. What we have, but is in very basic form. We have something on our wiki page at Raltier One. I have plans with Ian Collier to make the CVMFS Task Force wiki page the main point of contact. But even with this basic information, Raltier One, we know that sysadmins were able to use the information and to deploy the clients at their worker nodes, on their worker nodes.
You mentioned that a few times that it's always mounted at /CVMFS, so the paths are always consistent. Is that something we're sort of mandating as a standard requirement now? Because certainly I remember some sites have experimented in the past with mounting it at other places. There is nothing in CVMFS technically that stopped you from doing that. And there was certainly a theory that sites using the NFS re-export feature to make it available to things like shared university clusters and the like may well wind up with it mounted at other paths for those re-exports. So is that something that can definitely be relied on?
I do believe it's something which is configurable at CVMFS client level. Honestly, I didn't try anything else because I thought that /CVMFS is the same in every language and for every VO. I don't know about that re-export feature, which I have no knowledge about it. No, I'm fairly sure it's not hard-coded, but I have to check.
If it's possible to mount it in other places, then any users would need to make sure that they were basing any of their paths for their environment settings off some sort of movable route, like the VO software directory environment variables, rather than just assuming that everything will definitely be at /CVMFS, because I think there is the possibility that you will run across a site that's chosen to mount it somewhere else.
Thank you very much, Kathleen. We'll put a recording somewhere, but for now, thank you very much. That was cracking. Thank you, everyone, and I look forward to seeing you all on one of our next webinars at some stage.